or guaranteed cellular service regardless of your credit history. Get your prepaid ISIS cell phone today. Call 1-800-862-9327. Pick up the phone, America. It's for you.
Up next on Game Show Network, play Tattletales, followed by Super Decades and Trivia Track.
Gene Webern here. Join us next time for Match Game 74. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Tupman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.
On Game Show Network, anyone can win terrific prizes like this. The RainSoft computerized winter treatment system softens your water, filters, and purifies it, providing ideal water for every use in your home. From RainSoft.
A money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Conway.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. It's nice to have you with us. We have a terrific audience today. Boy, they're super. Divided into three sections, of course. Each one going to root for one of our celebrity couples. And I'm going to introduce those people to you right now. Here they are. First on my left is Patty Duke Aston and her husband, John Aston.
Jamie. Happy Wednesday to you.
How are you, John?
I'm fine, Berg.
Are you?
Yes.
You look terrific on the TV, you know.
Oh, gee. Thanks, Berg.
You're wearing a little suede there. Looks great.
Yeah, it's a lot of suede, actually.
Yeah. Well, we'll see it all when you come out front. And Patty, of course, you look lovely and beautiful
thank
as always.
You,
it's nice to have you with
I'm
us.
I'm having just the best time.
Are you? Good. Well, we are, too. Next to Patty and John is Claire and her husband, Scoey Mitchell.
Thank you, Berg. Thank you.
There they are. Scoey, how are you today?
I'm fine.
Now, in the meantime, John is standing up to show us the rest of his suede. Please, John, will you?
Am I supposed to stand up now?
No, Bert? You sit down now. We'll see it later.
I sit down now?
Oh, we're off to the races already, folks.
Okay.
Next to Claire and Scoey is that dimpled darling, Mitzi McCall, and her husband, Charlie Brill.
Yes.
Mitzi, I introduced you as being a dimple darling. Do you have dimples?
I have two dimples on my shoulders.
Oh,
I'm
glad we cleared that up.
I wanted them here, but somehow.
Yeah. Well, talk to me about it. We'll see what we can work out.
Okay.
All right. We're going to start them. What was that, John?
Okay.
John, we're trying to get off to a fast start here, John.
I won't mess around.
We're going to play a tattletale quickie, you guys. I'm going to ask you this question. For every correct answer, your rooting section gets $100. Don't give me the answer now. And here it is, fellas. It's addressed to you. Men.
Yes.
Most, and you too, Scoey. Most men. Well, I don't want to start picking on you now. I'm not going to do that. Men, most lovers say, I love you to each other with more or less frequency. Between you and your wife, who says I love you most often? don't let us know what you're thinking. Just think about it. I love you is said between most lovers with more or less frequency. Between you and your wife, who says I love you more often? Think about that. We'll come back to you in just a moment, fellas.
These questions are designed to create guilt, horrible guilt, on the part of the maid.
The name of the show is Tattletales, if you recall. And we want you
dear.
To tattle now and tell us, what's John going to say? Who says I love you most?
It's a pretty close tie, but he says it a lot. He's really very nice about that.
So
makes
you're going to
say,
good. You're going to say, he's going to say he says it most often.
Yeah. Unless he's afraid of me, and then he'll say I say it more.
Well, we're going to find that out in a minute. But you're going to say it's him.
Yeah.
Okay, let's bring on John. John.
Honey.
Yeah.
He's thinking about it. John, who says I love you most often between you and Patty?
Last week, she said it 111 times. I said 117 times, so I would say I...
That's what she said.
I love you, honey.
Thank you. She's ahead of me,
honey. I love you.
Thank you.
Don't turn us out. you.
117 times, huh? How'd you have time for anything else? That's a lot of time.
Oh, we can't get into that right now.
No, well, let's not. And we won't either. Thank you, John. Okay, Claire, what's Scoey going to say? How many? Who says it the most? I'm going to ask you how many times. Listen to me.
We two both say it a lot to each other, but
that's nice.
I think he's going to say he does.
Is it the truth, though? Is that a fact?
I think so.
He does?
Yeah.
Well, he's very
just
loving.
Just a little bit more.
That's very sweet.
So
all right.
Let's go with him.
Let's bring on Sweetie Pie now. Scoey.
Yeah.
Between the two of you, who does say I love you most often?
Yeah, that's kind of a hard question for me because, we don't say it that much verbally.
Yes.
No, I mean, we do little things like we buy each other gifts and stuff like that. Matter of fact, the other day she bought me a dozen eggs.
I'm going to cry.
Oh, no, that's sweet. That's sweet.
I guess she would say that she says it more than I do. But that's what I would guess, but my answer is...
Did you hear it, telltale buzz there, Scoey?
This show really points out to me that I really don't know her at all.
Well, yeah? Well, maybe by the end of the week you're going to get to know her.
Yeah.
Thank you, Scoey. I'm sorry. Claire, of course, said that you said it more often, which
well, that is the truth, but I didn't know she realized it.
Well, she did realize it.
Now you know.
And she
now
said
I
it, and now you know, and I'm sorry, no score there. Thank you, Scoey. It's been wonderful seeing you. Not only that, I feel that... He's gone. He can't hear me. Okay, Mitzi, what's Charlie going to say?
Well, girls, if you were married to anyone as cute as Charlie Brill... You'd say it more to him than he, you know, and I say it much more than he says it. Charlie, don't
and,
I?
And one lady in the red section went, yay!
Yeah, he is cute. Hands off.
So you say it more than he does.
I say it more than he does.
And that's what you think he's going to say?
Yes, I think that's what he's going to say.
All right, $100 is on the line. Let's bring on Charlie. Charlie!
Ooh, yes, I was just on the Merv Griffin show. It's been so long.
How did you do, all right?
Not bad.
Not bad. Tell us, who says I love you more?
Oh, often? Mitzi says it all the
That's
time.
That's what she said, you're right. At this point, Claire and Scoey have zero. Patty and John, Mitzi and Charlie are tied with $100 apiece, and we'll come back with more Tattletales right after this message for you.
Mr. Sandman. Remember when a quarter bought you three songs on the jukebox? And where you had the most fun hanging out with your friends?
Young love, first love.
Now relive those malt shop memories with 36 of the most romantic songs to ever come out of a jukebox.
Since I met you, baby, my whole life has changed. Earth Angel.
Shop Memories brings you 36 unforgettable songs by the greatest idols of the time.
See the pyramids along the Nile. Come with me, my Isle of Love. Teen Angel, can you hear me?
I'm sorry now.
A white short coat.
Shop Memories, 36 all-time classics on two cassettes or two CDs. Here's how to order.
Have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-361-0990. That's 1-800-361-0990. Call from U.S. or Canada. That's 1-800-361-0990. Or send $19.98 for two cassettes or $26.98 for two CDs plus $4.95 shipping to Malt Shop Memories, P.O. Box 1600, Libertyville, Illinois.
Trying to help Mitzi out because she says she's only 4'11 and she was afraid we couldn't see her. And I said, well, get Mitzi a pillow. And she says, I am on a pillow. What happens without the pillow? Do you disappear altogether?
Okay, watch this group.
There she goes, folks. Goodbye, Mitzi. It was Wonderful seeing you, Mitzi. Thank you for being with us. Okay, it's story time, fellas. I'm going to ask the ladies a question now, and they're going to give me a story and give me a clue, and we'll come back to you with that clue in just a minute. So tune out. Here you go, boys. Okay, goodbye, fellas. I thought they'd never leave. Ladies, you ready to go?
Yeah.
I'm going to take the first response and only the first response. You got to be first on that red button. Here we go. First question, and this is it. A story involving your wedding.
Mitzi.
Mitzi's up. All right, Mitzi, you want to tell us that story involving your wedding?
Well, my first... Charlie and I have been married to each other twice. My first wedding was like dumb, running like in the rain to a judge, and it was awful. But the second wedding was absolutely sensational because it was our first year's anniversary. And Charlie told me to get dressed up because he was going to take me out for dinner, right? Well, what do you think he did? He's really so sweet and sentimental. He drove to a temple, which is funny because we're not even Jewish. To a temple, and my cousin, who is a rabbi, officiated, and my mom and my dad and his mom and dad and all our relatives were there, and it was a beautiful anniversary present and quite a lovely wedding, I must say.
Well, that's very sweet. That's a lovely story. Now we need a one or two word clue that will turn the red section into screaming hysterical people.
Again? Right, wedding anniversary, gang. How's that?
Well, now that's two words. Now, two-word clue, of course, is worth $50.
They're going to say wedding,
no,
and then I'll just say
a story involving your wedding is the question.
And the clue is anniversary.
Anniversary, a one-word clue worth $100. And the red section has all agreed to that. And let's see if the fellas recognize it. Let's bring them on. All right, gentlemen, we've asked the ladies a question, and we have a clue. The question is a story involving your wedding. A story involving your wedding. The clue is... anniversary. Who was first? Wait a minute. Who was first? Charlie was first. Let's hear about that, Charlie.
Well, that's got to be... believe it or not, I married...
Let's hear about that, Charlie, if you will, please.
Believe it or not, I married that little run twice. And on our anniversary, it was a surprise thing, and everybody was at the temple, which is tough because we're Catholic.
That's what she said. You're right, Charlie. For $100 for your rooting section... It is now time, ladies and gentlemen, for our Tattletale Quickie, and I'm going
to
reach for it right now. Here it comes. Fellas, I asked you the question. Don't give me any answer now. Men, do you think we'd all be better off if women ran the world?
What?
Now, wait a minute now. Don't give me an answer now. Just think about that. Do you think we'd all be better off if women ran the world? Think about that, and we'll come back to you in just a moment for your answer. Patty, what's John going to say?
Mm-hmm.
Will he think, is what we're saying, of course.
I think that he thinks it would be best if men and women ran the world cooperatively.
Yes.
And he'll give you that whole prologue, too.
Right.
But he'll probably say, no, he doesn't think it would be better if women ran the world.
Okay, because that's right. We're dealing in semantics. It's
you agree to that.
Yes, and then the blue section agrees. And the yellow section says...
Then you marry him.
Okay, let's bring on John. John.
Yeah?
Do you think we'd all be better off if women ran the world?
They do already. I don't think they do, really. I was just kidding. I don't think it makes any difference, so I would say no.
That's what she said. You are right, sir.
Yes.
Oh, that was very nice.
Thanks, honey.
That beautifully, John. That was very nice how you did that.
Thanks, Bert.
I don't think there's a woman in the audience that despises you for that answer at all. No.
I hope not.
You handled that beautifully. Thank you, John. All right, Claire, what's Scoey going to say?
Scoey is going to say women should not handle the world.
He's going to say no.
No.
He doesn't think we'd be better off. Well, you say that kind of strongly. Does he... have any particular strong feelings about that?
Well, it's just that he thinks men are so much brighter in certain areas and women have their section. But as far as running the world, no.
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 So he, in certain areas, is what you're saying.
But he's going to say no. That's
right.
His answer.
Okay. Or as Orson Bean says, a women's place is in the stove. Okay, let's bring on Scoey.
Why?
Scoey, he's laughing already. Hey, what's going?
What?
What's happening?
I don't know.
Well, do you think we'd all be better off if women ran the world?
My wife took a long time again, huh?
No, she was fine.
I'm a male chauvinist pig. Now, that doesn't mean I don't have a high regard for the intelligence and the durability and the strength of womanhood.
Don't try to make up, Scully.
No, I do. I really do. But I just don't. I think men ought to run the world.
Well, all right. That's what you said, and you're right, sir. They were sweating you out, but you got there, Scully. Thank you. You're absolutely right with that one.
Thank
you. Okay, Mitzi, what's Charlie going to say?
Charlie's going to say that he thinks that men should run the world, but, the way I think about it and the way I figure it out is that I think women are kinder and more sentimental, and I don't think that we'd be in so much trouble if women did run the world. But Charlie would say that we're too emotional. That's because he's married to me and I cry at baseball games, but that's he'll say.
Okay, so he's going to say no. He does not think we would all be better off if women ran the world.
Right, he's going to say that.
Let's bring Charlie on. She's very definite. Charlie!
Yes, I'm here.
What is the answer? Do you think we'd all be better off if women ran the world?
They do and we're not.
And so the answer is...
No.
That's what she said, you're right. Hokey-dokey, at this point, Claire and Scully have $100, Patty and John have $200, Mitzi and Charlie in the lead with $300, and it is halftime, ladies to the rear. Gentlemen, come out here front and center, and we'll come back with more of Tattletales after a brief message for you. Please come back with us.
Replace your old roof now and pay as low as $96 a month. Don't wait. Your Sears Authorized Installed Roofing Professional says, buy it now before the busy season starts and choose your favorite roofing style with no money down and payments as low as $96 a month. It's our most affordable roofing option. Call this number now and have a Sears Authorized Roofing Expert provide you with a free in-home estimate. We're America's largest roofing installer. We do all the prep work and leave you with a beautiful, durable new roof. You'll get satisfaction guaranteed or your money back. Call today and take advantage of no money down and pay as low as $96 a month. This may be the perfect plan for your needs. So call your Sears Authorized Installation Professional right now. For installed roofing, gutters, doors, and fencing, call this 800 number right now. Improving your life by improving your home.
If you have trouble getting around and would love to regain your independence, Electric Mobility would like to give you a Rascal scooter free. Call for your free color catalog and enter the Rascal Mobility Sweepstakes. It's our way of introducing you to the benefits of owning a Rascal. Join over 100,000 Rascal riders who found Rascal to be the easiest to operate, easiest to transport, and easiest to afford. Your Rascal can be insurance or Medicare reimbursable.
My Rascal has given me a new lease on life.
I didn't get around much at home until I got my Rascal.
I was burdened other people. Now I'm independent.
I call it taking a walk. I jump on my Rascal and I take a walk.
Every month we give away another free Rascal. If you call right now, we'll give you up to 12 chances to win yours free. So call for your free color catalog. Call today. Don't delay. Next month's winner could be you.
To win a free Rascal, call 1-800-380-7171. That's 1-800-380-7171. Call now.
We are back. We have changed places.
Are we on the air?
We're on the air.
We are on the air. I thought you were going to say go back on and send your brother.
No. And I want to tell everybody that everybody's winning some money. Today, as they leave the studio, the money is put right in their hands. And if they're in the rooting section backing our top winning celebrity couple here, we'll add a bonus of $1,000 to the winnings that they've got together. All right, now. This is it, folks, and I'm going to start off with a question this time. I'm going to direct it to the fellas, and they're going to give us a story and a clue, ladies, and we'll come back to you with one clue in just a minute. So enjoy the music. Goodbye, ladies. All right, fellas, ready to go?
Yeah,
Hands upon the table.
Yeah, okay.
Here we go. No kidding around now. This is it. Here's the first question, a story about show business. Scully Mitchell.
Would you repeat that, please?
Would you like me to repeat?
John says, would you repeat that, please? Okay, Scoey, you are up, sir. Tell us a story about show business, if you will.
This is not a funny story.
Well, then we don't want to hear it. You got one, John?
Yeah, it's not a funny story.
Oh, don't break your trend. Go ahead.
It's a nice story. One of the grandest men in this business, Mr. Jimmy Durante, and he was doing a show in Columbus, Ohio, working one of the theaters in the round. And he got a call from the Veterans Hospital, and they asked him, would he come over and do a show for the people, for the fellas at the hospital. And he said, gee, you know, I'd love to come over, but I have television commitments, I have radio commitments, I have interviews, and I have to work at the theater at night, and I'm just not as young as I used to be, and I really couldn't fit it into my schedule. And they said, just one song, we'll pick you up, we'll bring you over here, we'll take you back, we'll make sure. So he consented. They go to the hospital, and he sings one song, right? And he's walking off the stage, and the fellas are applauding, and he stops, he walks back on stage, and he does an hour. Right? So he gets to the theater about an hour and a half late, and the theater owner says, what are you trying to put me out of business? He says, let me explain it to you. And he went out and he talked to the audience, and he said, ladies and gentlemen, I know you've been here a long time. He says, but what I want you to know is I went over to the Veterans Hospital, and I promised to do one song. He said, and I did one song, and as I was walking off the stage, he said, there were two fellas sitting down front in wheelchairs, and one had lost the left arm, the other had lost the right arm. He said, and when I saw those two fellas clapping on each other's hands, there was just no way I could leave, so I just did an hour for
them. Wow, what a story.
Isn't that a beautiful story?
Yeah, that's lovely. Okay. Yeah. It is a lovely story.
I'd like to tell one, too.
John, we've got one now. What we need now from Scoey is a clue that Claire's going to recognize. One or two clues.
I hope she recognizes it because she's not really familiar with this.
They're turning on us.
I'm sorry, folks.
Scoey, you back up. I'll cover you. They can't take all of us.
Good story.
What's it going to be?
Hospital.
Hospital. A story about show business. Hospital's good right. clue. One-word clue worth $100. Let's bring on the ladies. All right, ladies, we have a story and we have a clue. Here is the question first. A story about show business. Story about show business. The clue is hospital. Claire! Tell us about it, Claire.
Oh, that has to be the story about Jimmy Durante.
That's the story it is. You're absolutely right. Thank you, dear. Okay, at this point, we have a very close game. Patty and John, Claire and Scoey have $200. Mitzi and Charlie are in the lead with $300 for the red section. And we shall return shortly with more of Tattletales after this message for you. Please come back.
You know a toilet's favorite stain remover is Clorox Bleach. But bleach doesn't stick to the sides of the bowl where the stains hang out. That's why we created new Clorox Bleach Toilet Bowl Cleaner. Now with twice as much Clorox Bleach in a gel that sticks to stubborn stains till they're gone. Leaves the bowl sparkling clean and sanitary too, with a nice fresh scent. Mm-hmm. New Clorox Bleach Toilet Bowl Cleaner. The bleach that sticks to stains.
We had just moved into our new place. We didn't realize how much stuff we were going to need. But we both were working, and we thought, hey, we can handle this. And then Mike's company downsized.
Erica Fleming talks about the day she called Genus Credit Management.
So Mike's trying to find a new job. Meanwhile, all these bill collectors are calling us. It got so bad that a lawyer friend of Mike's said he was going to help us file for bankruptcy.
There's a place to call for help, and the service is free.
Genus Credit Management, this is Ken. How may I
help? We don't make loans. Instead, we work with nearly 40,000 banks and other creditors to help you become debt-free.
We couldn't believe it. I mean, they got our payments down.
Yeah, way down.
Get all your bills together, then give us a call. In 30 minutes, we can lower your payments and start getting you out of debt.
Mike just had a really good interview. I think we're going to be okay.
Yeah, but I don't know what we'd have done if we hadn't called him.
Don't wait till things get bad. Call Genus Credit Management. It's not a loan. It's a way out of debt.
And I don't know anything about that. Hi,
guys.
What? Okay, we're back. We're going to play a tattletale quickie. Ladies, I'm going to ask you the question. You know the rules. Don't give me an answer now. Just think about it. Here it is. Girls, in general, do you think that men have their minds on sex more than women do? In general. Now, this is in general. Remember, that's not talking about you or your husband. In general, do you think that men have their minds on sex more than women do? Think about that. We'll come back to you in a moment. Wonder what they're thinking about. John, what's Patty going to say?
Sex. I mean...
No. Do you think she'll say that men have their minds on sex more?
Yes, yes.
Do you think that's a fact?
Do I?
Yeah.
Sex? Yes.
No.
Yes.
John.
Yes, I do.
You do think men have their minds on sex more than women?
I agree with you.
Okay. Absolutely. Yeah. I feel like I would...
Yeah.
Okay,
right.
Bring on Patty. Yeah. Oh, Patty, I'm having the best time. Patty, do you think that men have their minds on sex more than women do?
Oh, I'm sorry, I was thinking about sex. What?
I said, do you think that men have their minds on sex more than women do?
Yes!
That's what he said. Yeah. Thank you, Patty. Scoy. Scoy, what's Claire going to say?
Oh, she's definitely going to say yes.
Yes, that men have their minds on sex more than women.
No, she'll definitely say yes.
She'll definitely say yes. Yeah. Maybe you.
No, my wife accuses me of being warm.
Overly warm.
That's the nicest way I can say
it. So you're going to say yes.
Yes.
She will say that men do. Let's bring her on. All right, Claire, do you think that men have their minds on sex more than women do?
Yes,
men That's what
do.
He said. You're right. Thank you, dear. I don't want to put a jinx on you, Charlie, but we have a tie game. Everybody's got $300.
Easy question.
Easy question?
Yeah.
What's the answer?
What is the question?
The question was...
Do I think that...
Men have their minds on sex more than
no
women?
No way. No, they don't. And Mitzi knows that they don't. Watch.
Not more. The question is not more.
Not more. Just the girls also get those thoughts in their minds.
All right. Let's bring on Mitzi and see if she agrees with you. Mitzi? Here it is. In general, do you think men have their minds on sex more than women do?
Yes.
Our time is up. We have a tie. Everybody wins. We have a tie game. Everybody wins. Everybody has $300. We had $1,000 of that. Our three rooting sections will divide $1,900. With more of Tattletale after this message as pandemonium reigns.
Get ready to play. Join your favorite celebrities and host Alan Ludden on Password Plus.
This is more than just Password, you know?
It's Password Plus.
Catch Password Plus every weekend on Game Show Network.
Turn your tap water into wonderful water with Brita. It's certified to remove sediment, chlorine, and 99% of lead. Brita.
Oh, no. Not an offer for another credit card.
We've never gotten one like this.
What is it? Made of gold?
Better. This one's a First USA Platinum Visa card.
Uh-huh. At a platinum price. I mean, how much are they talking about? $300, $400 a year just for the privilege?
It's free. No annual fee.
Well, what kind of interest?
Fixed introductory rate is 3.9% APR. Oh, that's the lowest I remember seeing. Maybe we should switch.
You don't have to be wealthy to apply for a First USA Platinum Visa card. Just responsible. Having one is a credit to the way you manage your finances. So don't wait. Call this toll-free number now. Imagine all the money you could save transferring your existing high-interest balances to our low six-month rate. And how much you can continue to save when the rate goes to a still low fixed APR of just 12.99%.
We don't really need another credit card.
What we don't need is paying out all that interest on the cards we have now. Whoa, listen to this. A credit line up to $100,000. That's all the credit we need. And look, a year-end summary of all our charges, warranty manager service to protect our big ticket purchases, up to $1 million in travel accident insurance.
$3,000 lost luggage protection, auto rental collision coverage. Hey,
Let's give him a call.
Call 1-800-608-8834 now and apply by phone for your first USA Platinum Visa card. It's your reward for your good money management. The low introductory APR is just 3.9%. Call toll-free today, 1-800-608-8834.
Imagine us with a first USA Platinum Visa card. We deserve it.
Like giving us credit for our good credit.
How about some credit for my good idea?
Call this toll-free number now and apply by phone. 1-800-608-8834.
Up next on Game Show Network plays Super Decades, followed by Trivia Track and The Price is Right.
We're all out of time. We had a three-way tie today. Everybody in the audience goes home happy. I hope you did too. Bert Comey saying so long, everybody. See you next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Game Show Network, all play, all day.
Tonight, one everyone who loves to sew, specially priced, the Model 108 from Janome, new home sewing machine company.
Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip. Tattletales! And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convey!
Okay, here we go. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us. We've got a terrific group today. We have a terrific group back there, too. Our studio audience is divided into three sections, rooting for our celebrity couples. Let's meet them now. Shall we do that? First of all, you little Dickens.
You're cutie.
He's a funny guy, and you all are crazy about Charlie Brill and his funny wife, Mitzi McCall.
You can applaud, too. This is not for the game.
Hi, Mitzi, how you doing?
Hi, sweetheart.
You ready to go?
I'm ready to go, and I hope I don't make any mistakes, because if I do, will you walk me home?
Yes, I will. And next to Charlie and Mitzi is Mr. John Astin and his wife, Patty Duke Astin. It is certainly nice to have you with us, Patty. And
thank you.
And you too,
it's
John.
Nice to have been had.
Two wonderful... I beg your pardon?
What did she say?
Moving right along, folks. Next to Patty and John. There
say?
He is. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Scoey Mitchell and his wife, Claire. All right,
those are my
gang.
People.
Those are your people in the
Let
red section over there.
Go.
Okay, are you all ready to go? Let's start things off with a tattletale quickie, and here it is right here in the box. Ladies, I'm going to ask you the question. Each correct answer is worth $100 to your rooting section. Don't give me the answer. Here it is. Ladies, if a wife finds her husband is unfaithful, which is the better course of action? To confront him with it immediately or say nothing and hope it blows over? Don't give me a reaction, Heather. Let us hear it. Ladies, if a wife finds her husband is unfaithful, which is the better course of action? To confront him with it immediately or say nothing and hope it blows over? Now, I must tell you that that's a general question. This is not about you and your fellow sitting out here. What's the better course of action? Think about it, ladies. We'll come back to you in a moment for your answer. Now, just between us, Charlie.
Oh, my.
What's Mitzi going to say about that one?
Well, I tell you, Mitzi is the violent jealous type.
Yes.
And she would cut.
Yes, she would.
She would confront you right away. Not a moment. She would right away.
She's a little lady with a great big gun.
A big mouth and a punch.
So the answer is she will confront...
Right away.
She would confront the man immediately.
Not only would she, I would too.
Well, this is if a wife. But you'll say she'll say the wife should confront immediately.
What?
Never mind. I know what I mean.
Did you ask me a question,
Charlie?
What, what did you say, Bert? Tell him.
No, never mind.
Doesn't matter.
We know. The blue section and I know what we're talking about. Or in me, whichever it is. Let's bring on Mitzi. Mitzi, what should the wife do? Should she confront him with it immediately or say nothing and hope it blows over?
Kill.
I think that means confront him with it, doesn't it? We'd say that's a correct answer, yes, worth $100. I don't have kill on my card, but I think that means confront him. Thank
right.
you, Mitzi, that's
okay.
absolutely right. John, what's Patty going to say? What should that wife do?
Well, you're asking me what the woman should do, which mm-hmm. is not really my area.
Well, it could be of great concern to you, however.
Yeah. If he can continue that, monsieur, is someone... That's not going to work, is it? Well, I would say that... I don't know if I should... tolerate that, or should I hit him in the mouth?
No. We're moving right along
okay,
here. This is a tattletale quickie, folks.
I think she would say... the intelligent thing might be to confront him with it right away.
Confront him immediately. All right. That's what he says. Let's bring her on and see if she agrees. Patty?
I'm so angry right now from thinking about it for so long.
Yes. What should that wife do? Confront him with it or say nothing?
First, you wait till he's sleeping.
Yes.
And you beat him up.
Right.
And then if he can still talk, you confront him with it.
Confront him with it? That's what he said. You're right. Thank you, Patty. Scoey, what's Claire going to say? Are you worried about it? It's a general question, you know. You have nothing to fear here. We're not pointing the finger or anything.
I really don't even know how to answer this question because my wife is a very even-tempered, easygoing, really, seriously.
Yes.
She's very, not passive, but...
But we're not talking about your wife, you know. This is a wife, a general question. What should a wife do if a wife finds mm-hmm. a husband is unfaithful? What should she do? Should she confront him or wait till it blows over?
Well, if she's unfaithful with me, wait until it blows over. If it's somebody else, okay, confront him right away. You know.
what's Claire going to say, however?
I think Claire would say, if he really means that much to you, maybe you could wait a while and hope it...
The red section is turning hostile.
Excuse me just a moment. I'd like to straighten something out. Would you excuse
Go
me?
Ahead.
Have faith, folks. You did that a while ago? Oh, it's up. No, I think she'll say, wait, let it blow over. Then if it doesn't blow over, confront him with it.
Now, but your choice, your answer for the question
let
is...
Let it blow over.
Let it blow over. Let's bring
I
on...
I think. We haven't had the problem yet, but...
No, well...
I hope that's the way she would react.
Yes, well, for your sake, I hope so too, Scully. Let's bring on Claire. Claire,
yes.
What should that wife do? Confront him or let it blow over?
In all honesty, I would just let it blow over.
That's what he said, and you are right. Absolutely right. You see, have faith, the man says. At this point, at the beginning of our game, we have a tie score. Mitzi, Charlie, Patty, John, Claire, and Scoy have $100, a tie game, and we will come back with more of Tattletales, a lot more, in just a moment. Please come back with us.
There's something new growing in the valley. Introducing Garden Vegetable Ranch. Hearty vegetables blended with the original ranch. Only from Hidden Valley. There's a garden in every bottle.
Do you need a Visa credit card? If you can say yes to these minimum requirements, we'll say yes to you. This is a special opportunity to get an unsecured Visa credit card with no security deposit required, even if you've been turned down before and regardless of your past credit history. Almost everyone will be approved for this Visa credit card, so call now. Repeat, if you can say yes to these minimum requirements, we'll say yes to you. Say yes to this limited no-risk offer for an unsecured Visa credit card from Cross Country Bank. Call this toll-free number now.
Hi, I'm Dick Clark, and now everyone can enjoy the freedom of the new Isis cellular phone from Philips thanks to prepaid cellular.
Introducing prepaid cellular from Worldwide Direct. With prepaid cellular phone cards, there's no monthly bills.
Take the phone just in case.
Thank you.
And no contract, no credit check, and no deposit. Got car trouble?
My car's broken down. Can you come and help?
Help is just a call away. So forget those outrageous phone bills. With prepaid cellular phone cards, buying airtime is easy. Order from home and the phone arrives at your door ready to use. Get the Philips Isis prepaid cellular phone, a $199 value, now just three easy payments of $33. And there's no contract, no credit check, no deposit, and no monthly bills.
So pick up the phone, America. It's for you.
Now, for only three payments of $33, you're guaranteed cellular service regardless of your credit history. Call 1-800-840-9872. Pick up the phone, America. It's for you.
Okay, we're back. We have a tie game. Good game, too. And it's time for a story. All right, ladies, this means I'm going to ask the fellas a question. They're going to tell us a story. One of them is who gets in first on that red button and give us a clue. And we'll be back to you with that clue in just a minute. Goodbye now. See you in a minute. Gentlemen, are you ready to go?
Yeah, yes.
Hands upon the tables?
Yes.
Minds alert, sitting up straight, ready to go. Yeah. Here's the first question. A memorable quotation. A memorable quotation. John. The other two fellas are staring in bewilderment.
And now he's got to think of something.
And he's got to come up with one. John, okay. let's have that memorable quotation, sir.
Okay.
To be or not to be.
No.
Many years ago, two of my sons, David and Alan, were discussing, it was during the Vietnam War, and we were talking about how long the war was going on, and that maybe someday, unfortunately it went on and on and on, David would have to go into the service and go into the war, and we thought that would be a very unfortunate thing. And his younger brother sat there and he heard the whole thing, and after it was all finished and he looked up and he said, "And that will be the end of David." that's a little story about sibling rivalry.
Yes, and, I think it's a memorable quotation.
You think that's funny?
That was a question.
Anyway, the clue...
The clue.
That's a memorable quotation.
A memorable quotation.
And
we need
clue
a clue.
Is
war.
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 Yeah.
All right. Let's bring on the ladies.
No. Okay.
Ladies, we have asked the fellas a question. We have a clue. The question is a memorable quotation. Memorable quotation. The clue is war. Patty.
I think it's a good old Big Al again. Our 13-year-old son, many years ago, he and John and our oldest son, David, were discussing the war in Vietnam. And
that's what he said. You're right. You're absolutely right. Okay. It is time for a tattletale quickie, and so my hand is moving to the quickie box. And there it goes. Here's a question, ladies, a tattletale quickie. $100 a piece for each correct answer. Ladies, are you all right, Patty? Ladies, if you thought that something intriguing was going on in the next room, would you stoop to look through the keyhole? Ladies, if you thought that something intriguing was going on in the next room, would you stoop to look through the keyhole? Think about that. We shall return to you in just a moment. Charlie, what's Mitzi going to say?
Mitzi would kick the door down, not look through.
Just the answer is yes.
Oh, yes.
All right, the answer is yes. Let's bring on Mitzi. Mitzi, what would you do if you thought something intriguing was going on over there? Would you stoop to look through the keyhole?
I would stoop so good to give a look right through that keyhole with a glass.
That's what he said,
head.
And you're right. Thank you, darling. John, what would Patty do?
Erase the 18 and a half minute gap. She would not look.
She wouldn't look?
No.
Really?
Really.
She's not
in the next room.
She's she's not the curious type.
No, too principled. She would feel that it would be intrusion, honestly.
Okay, let's bring her on, see if she agrees with you. Patty, what
yes.
would you do? But that intriguing, whatever's going on in the other room, would you look through the keyhole?
But I don't want to sound like a prude, but I wouldn't. But I'd be dying to, but I wouldn't.
That's what he said. You're right.
I'm just too scared to
go. Very nice. Thank you, Patty.
Thank you.
Scoy, what's Claire going to say? What would she do in a case like that?
Well, the only reason Claire would ever stoop to look through the keyhole was because of the height of the keyhole.
Because of the...
It's just a bad joke, Bert.
I'm sorry.
No, my wife would not. Definitely. Thanks, John. Didn't mean to wake you up. No, my wife, it has nothing to do with principles or anything. My wife just wouldn't be interested.
Wouldn't be interested?
No.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll see. Let's bring on Claire. Claire?
Yes?
What would you do? Would you stoop to look through the keyhole if you thought something intriguing was going on in the next room?
I sure would. I don't want to miss out on a good thing.
Okay.
But
somehow I had a feeling.
No. Bert,
yeah.
You didn't let me finish.
Oh, I'm sorry, Scoy. You weren't finished. I didn't realize that.
That's the way she was when I first met her, but she has changed quite a bit.
Oh, I see.
She definitely would look through the keyhole.
Well, she didn't change quick enough for that question. I'm very sorry. At this point, Claire and Scoy have $100. Mitzi and Charlie have $200. Patty and John are in the lead with $300. Let's change places, fellas. You step to the rear, and ladies, come on out here. While we're changing places, we're going to break away for a brief message. Come back.
If you have trouble getting around and would love to regain your independence, Elected Mobility would like to give you a Rascal scooter free. Call for your free color catalog and enter the Rascal Mobility Sweepstakes. It's our way of introducing you to the benefits of owning a Rascal. Join over 100,000 Rascal riders who found Rascal to be the easiest to operate, easiest to transport, and easiest to afford. Your Rascal can be insurance or Medicare reimbursable.
My Rascal has given me a new lease on life.
I didn't get around much at home until I got my Rascal.
I was burdened to other people. Now I'm independent.
I call it taking a walk. I jump on my Rascal and I take a walk.
Every month we give away another free Rascal. If you call right now, we'll give you up to 12 chances to win yours free. So call for your free color catalog. Call today. Don't delay. Next month's winner could be you.
To win a free Rascal, call 1-800-380-7171. That's 1-800-380-7171. Call now.
I understand you have a problem. Roaches invade your house while you sleep and you can't kill them. Permit me. New combat quick kill formula. Night after night it kills and kills, and death comes quickly. I like that. You sleep. We'll wait up.
You're in control of the board. Take a category.
$10,000. Here's your first
summer.
$10,000. Here's your first
$100,000.
Game Show Network. Have you played today?
Okay, we're back. We have changed places. I have the ladies out here with me. The fellas are on the television screens. Everybody's won some money. We have a good game today, too. Terrific couples, too. Don't you think? They're really super. Now, as you know, our audience is divided into three sections, but whichever one of these rooting sections is backing our final winner for today, we're going to give them an extra $1,000 to take home with them. Okay, fellas, we're going to start off now with a story question, okay? We're going to ask the ladies now. We're going to get a clue from them, and we'll come back to you in just a moment, so enjoy the music. We'll be back in just a second. Bye.
Bye.
Ladies, ready to go? Hands upon the table. Here we go. I'll only take one response, and this is the question. A really embarrassing moment. You started like this. All right, Patty. Tell us about the embarrassing moment.
The embarrassing moment happened on this very show. The last time John and I were here, you asked a question about when we first met, would my husband say that he said, that's the girl I'm going to marry? And I said, oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I don't mean to sound egotistical, but absolutely. And you put John on, and he said, absolutely not. And I have never been so embarrassed in my life.
Well, I certainly hope it doesn't happen again. We'll
and
find
it's
out.
About to, right?
No, it's. Let's find out. What we need now is a clue that John's going to recognize.
Is tattletale one word?
Yes, but will we allow that as a clue? Why not?
Ha ha ha.
I look over our producer and says, I don't know, what do you want to do, Bert? Okay, that's it. One word clue and it's tattletale. Okay, that'll confuse the heck out of them.
Tattletales.
Tattletales. Okay, let's bring on the fellas. Gentlemen, we have asked the ladies a question and we have a clue. Here's the question. A really embarrassing moment. The clue is tattletales. John. Tell us about it.
Right now, if I don't know the answer. No, it was the last time we did the show, and misunderstood. One person understood one. When did
sure,
you first
sure,
meet, and the other person
don't
understood
have.
The first
Yeah, right. Okay, you're right. Interesting. When John tells a story, it comes out as a misunderstanding
yes,
of the question,
right.
Isn't that
no,
interesting?
No,
at this
actually,
point, Clarence
truth,
Goy
Bert?
Have $100, Mitzi and Charlie
have
two.
The way you read the question, Bert, that's what it was.
Patty and John are in the lead with $400 for the other segment. We shall return in a moment with more of Tattletales. Please come back with us.
Game Show Network presents Win TV, a new way to experience television. Win TV gives you more Q&A.
Fantastic, but you know, you folks have a little extra something going for you today. You really do.
More prizes, more chances to win.
89, it is!
Watch Win TV. It gives you more of what you watch Game Show Network for. Your chance to experience Win TV comes Monday, August 17th.
Intimate song is a celebration of love. When I need you. Now get Touched by Love, a new 36-song collection of the most popular soft rock hits.
Darling, if you want me to be closer to you, get closer to me.
I love you. I honestly love you.
Magic of love in every song.
Sometimes when we touch, the honesty's too much.
Touched by Love brings you 36 of the most romantic songs of our time.
Turn the other way. Baby, I love you to want me the way that I want you. But there's a warm wind blowing the stars around. And I'd really love to see you tonight. Even the nights are better.
Touched by Love is not sold in stores, so order now.
And I will love you so always.
Just you. Call this toll-free number now for Touched by Love. Two cassettes, $19.98, two CDs, $26.98, plus $4.95 shipping. Call now.
Okay, we're back. I have a tattletale quickie for the fellas. Here it is, gentlemen. Listen carefully. If you had your choice of one of the following, which would you take? An Oscar for the best performance or $100,000 a year tax-free for the rest of your life?
Oh, that's me.
They're all groaning. Fellas, if you had your choice of one of the following, which would you take? An Oscar for the best performance or $100,000 tax-free for the rest of your life a year? Think about it, gentlemen. We'll come back in a minute. Oh, that is a good one, isn't it? That's tough. Mitzi, what would Charlie say?
My Charlie?
The audience is buzzing because they don't know what they do either. Oh, I guess they do. Oh, they think it's easy. Well, do you think it's easy?
It's a very, very difficult, very difficult, especially like if you love what you're doing, you know, love being in this business. But I have to be honest, my Charlie, I think, will take the 100th vow tax-free.
Let's bring Charlie on and see where his heart lays. Or lies. Charlie.
Oh, no. Oh God.
What would you do? Oh. Would it be an Oscar or 100 grand a year?
I'd like to thank the Academy. I'm such an egotist in this business. I guess we all are. I would have to have that Oscar.
Well,
to wrap it around Mitzi's neck.
Maybe you could melt it down and keep you for a couple of months, Charlie. I'm sorry, that's not what she said. Thank you.
Oh,
Patty, I'm glad that you girls were out here in front because you've got an Oscar.
Yeah.
Now, what would John do?
It's really tough because he loves his work, and I think he really wants people to appreciate it, and he has a nomination. But I'll tell you something, he doesn't think that that actors should compete like that. He thinks it's an unfair position to put them in. So you see my dilemma.
Yes, I do.
Plus which, we got 5 kids to put through college. Take the money, John.
Okay, you'll say take the money. Okay, let's see if he does. John? John?
Yeah?
What's the choice, an Oscar or 100 grand a year?
Both.
Here we go again.
No, I would, because the performance would be the same whether I got the Oscar or not, I would take the money.
That's what she said. She said you take the money. You're right, John. Thank you. All right, Claire. Claire, what's Scoey going to say?
Scoey is going to take the money and run.
Take
I guarantee
the money
and
run.
Your red section.
Guarantee.
The money. The money.
All right. I love it when they're so positive, don't you? Guaranteed he's going to take the money and run.
Absolutely.
Let's see what he says. Let's bring him on. Scoey.
Yeah.
What is it, an Oscar or 100 grand a year?
Well, I found out at an early age that money will buy everything but poverty.
Right? Right.
And I know too many people living without an Oscar, but I don't know nobody living without no money. Money.
That's what she money. Said. You're right.
Money.
Okay, you can buy a couple Oscars for 100 grand a year, right? All right, that time is up. That's the assistant, Patty and John, are the big winners today for the Yellow Section. Patty and John, you have won $500.
Fix.
We had $1,000 to that for a total for your winning section of $1,500. Okie doke, gang. We'll come back with more of Tattletales in just a moment after this message for you.
Get ready to play.
Love. Hate.
Despair.
You'll see it all on the original Newlywed Game. And then, the game of love continues. Bob Eubanks is back on the new Newlywed Game. Catch the Newlywed Game at 7:30 p.m. Eastern, 4:30 p.m. Pacific, followed by the new Newlywed Game, weekdays on Game Show Network.
We should greet each and every day like a gift that's come our way. Share the rich Folgers brew and make someone's day brighter too. That aroma mountain grown, pass it on, set the morning's tone. Feel the warmth and say, let's unwrap this day.
Michelle never cleans her shower, yet it's clean every day with new Tilex Fresh Shower. After each shower, spray a gentle mist. Don't scrub or rinse. Now you'll never have to clean your shower again. Try new Tilex Fresh Shower.
You love your cat, but hate that litter pan. Introducing the patented Littermate Cat Box. The only cat box that automatically cleans cat litter after every use.
When I return from work, there is no odor, there is no mess, no effort made on my part.
The amazing Littermate Cat Box is always on duty. 10 minutes after your cat uses the Littermate, the cleaning rake automatically goes into action. Motion detectors know when the coast is clear. If another cat needs to use the Littermate, the cleaning cycle resets.
It is very important for cat owners to always keep their cat's litter box clean. And Littermate makes it especially easy.
With Littermate, you'll never scoop or change, sift or lug cat litter again.
Littermate is worth it. My cats and I are worth it.
Over 500,000 cats enjoy the veterinarian-approved Littermate Cat Box.
To order now or for more information, call 1-800-807-1184.
Up next on Game Show Network plays Super Decades, followed by Trivia Track and The Price is Right.
We're back. Do you know that we established a record today on Title Tales because John and Patty Duke Aston have won $1,500 for the rooting section. That's the most any couple has ever won for one rooting section. How about that? We'll be congratulated. Now, while I've got you all in a good mood, you two are doing something that we should be watching for. I want everybody at home to
nothing.
Know that.
We're not doing anything.
You're not doing anything.
No.
Oh, you are too.
We broke up since the show.
Oh, no.
We're going to go on tour with Ann Margaret this summer.
Oh, are you? Where are you going to
be?
All over?
All over. Las Vegas and Reno and Tahoe and everywhere.
Oh, terrific. Well, then we will watch for them, won't we? In
yes,
Vegas
sir.
And Tahoe and Reno. We hope you'll be watching for us on CBS. Great commentary. So long, Miss Adams.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Title Tales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.
Game Show Network. All play, all day.
Finished in distressed pine solids and veneers. Furnished by Broyhill.
Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us today. We have a superb audience today, divided into three sections, each one rooting for one of our celebrity couples. Let's meet the couples now. Shall we do that? First, on my left, first time on our show, you have enjoyed her low these many years on Gunsmoke, Miss Amanda Blake and her husband, Frank Gilbert, backstage. It's nice to have you both with us.
Nice to be here, Bert.
Frank, you hear me okay back there?
Oh, yes, I hear you fine, Bert.
Okay, you guys are rookies, so we'll be watching you
closely today. New kids
on
the block.
That's right. Next, Amanda and Frank, is a lovely actress and her lovely husband, Marcy Lafferty Shatner and William Shatner. I didn't mean to say you were lovely. You're okay, Bill. Big fella.
He's lovely,
good
too.
To see you.
Thank you, and next Marcy. Thank you, Bert. Thank you, world.
Next to Marcy and Bill are practically our resident crazies. Everybody knows Blondie. Oh, yes. Elaine Joyce and her husband, Bobby Van.
Hello there! Yay! Yay! Yay!
Hey, Bobby.
What?
You were terrific. I went up to see Bobby in Las Vegas.
Yes, you did.
And I have to tell everybody how terrific you were.
Thank you. You were terrific for coming, too, Bert.
Wasn't I terrific?
Yes, wonderful.
Yes, and
let's have it for Bert.
I'll send the bill over to you later.
Okay, thank you.
I'm not going.
Okay, what we're going to do this time, we're going to start off with a tattletale quickie. That's the way we're going to start the game off today. And so that means, fellas, I'm going to ask you the question, and you're not going to give me the answer now. You're going to think about it.
Wouldn't think of it.
Here it comes. Men, when it comes to your wife, would you say that you are possessive? Man, when it comes to your wife, would you say that you're possessive? Mm. Now, each correct answer is worth $100 to your rooting section. Go away and think about it. We'll come back to you in just a moment. Now, Amanda, what's Frank going to say? When it comes to you, is he possessive, you think?
It's absolutely incredible.
It is?
Yeah.
He's very possessive.
Not at all.
He is really unbelievably possessive.
What do you mean, he gets violent?
No, he doesn't get violent. He gets violent inside, and his eyes turn white. You know, the color turns white.
He doesn't mind me out here talking to you now, does he? I don't want to...
No, that's all right.
I don't want to cross him.
But he's... Oh, God, unbelievably possessive.
So I guess the answer is yes, then, isn't it?
Oh, very good, Bert.
See, I pick up fast, man. Got a mind like a steel trap. Okay, let's bring on Frank, then. Hey, Frank.
Hi.
When it comes to Amanda, would you say that you were possessive?
Well, I wouldn't start out by saying that, but definitely I would, really, I'm very possessive.
That's what she said, you're right.
I know.
You, that's what Amanda said.
That?
You scared us for a second, though, didn't you?
God.
Thank you, Frank. Okay, Marcy, what's Bill gonna say?
Well, he is possessive. I don't know if he knows that he is, though.
Oh.
But I'll say yes.
He's sneaky possessive.
Yeah, I think so.
Just
yes.
The veins stand out and so forth.
Right. Popping it.
Do you give him reason to be concerned about
me? No reason.
No reason at all.
Oh, tame.
What's she going to say? I sure do. Okay.
He's possessive.
You will say yes, he is. Let's bring on Bill. All right, Bill. We're going to beam you down right now, Captain Kirk.
Oh,
what
Bert,
is the,
I thought you'd never mention it.
What is the answer? Does that mean yes?
No, that's the MGM line.
Oh, okay, are you possessive, Bill, yes or no?
I am.
Yes, that's what you said. Hi. All right. Thank you, Bill. Okay, Elaine.
This is what you call the hot seat.
Yeah, this is it.
I mean, if he's not possessive, then I am totally unloved, right?
Oh, no, I wouldn't say that. I love you, and I'm not the least bit possessive about you. I'll share you with Bobby if he insists.
Bobby is definitely possessive.
He is.
Thoroughly. I mean, he watches everything I do, and he doesn't make any bones about it. He just cares an awful lot, so he's very possessive. He'll say yes.
Do you equate possessiveness with love, then? You do.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Because
it's like, you know, if you don't want people walking on your grass and stuff like that, you're possessive about it.
Yeah, I know, but
get out of my lawn, you know?
But I don't love my grass the way he loves you, I don't think.
Oh.
No, I wouldn't say so. You'll say yes.
Oh, he'll say yes.
Let's bring on Bobby. Bobby, what's the answer? Yes or no?
Well,
are you possessive?
Am I possessive? Well, if a man is not possessive of his wife, then he really doesn't love her, I guess. I would think. So I would say, as I said to her this morning, I love you, and she said to me, will you get out of here? I don't need you. I remember that. No, yes, I am possessive.
That's what she said, you're right. And that means, at this point, we have a tie game.
Yay!
Everybody's got $100, and we're going to break away for a commercial message and come back and see how all of this turns out. Please come back, baby.
All right.
It's time for a toast, but first you gotta go and hug that host. So spread your arms out wide like you just don't care. And if you don't weigh much, throw him up in the air. You gotta grab him and squeeze him. There's no time to think. You just may fall in love when you're hugging Wink. So if you won't stand still, then tie him down. Cause hugging a host may be the best prize in town.
Your morning shower. Rich cleansing lather awakens while Olay moisturizers soften. It's the simple joy of being clean and feeling cared for. But feeling is believing, so prove it to yourself with Olay moisturizing body wash.
Do you need a Visa credit card? If you can say yes to these minimum requirements, we'll say yes to you. This is a special opportunity to get an unsecured Visa credit card with no security deposit required, even if you've been turned down before and regardless of your past credit history. Almost everyone will be approved for this Visa credit card, so call now. Repeat, if you can say yes to these minimum requirements, we'll say yes to you. Say yes to this limited no-risk offer for an unsecured Visa credit card from Cross Country Bank. Call this toll-free number now.
Hey, you heard about that guy, Sean?
He's so cool. No one's ever scored that many points.
Dude, he's going to any college he wants.
The man is unbelievable.
There he is. He is so smart.
From the software for the SATs to the educational and internet enhancements, there's nothing like the new Compaq Creative Learning Series. Home computers that can help kids do better in school so they'll do better in life. Only at Radio Shack.
It's really not that complicated. Let's try it again, okay?
Okay, we're back. We have a tie game at this point. Good one, too. Let's move right along with the story question here, fellas. You know how we play. I'm going to ask the ladies a question.
Yeah.
I'm going to get one response, and then I'll come to you with a clue in just a minute, all right?
Okay.
See you in a minute.
Bye.
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 Ready to go? Here we go, ladies. Here's the first question. It happened in New York. Elaine. All three of you looked like you were starting out on the Australian crawl.
It did. I looked out of the corner of my eye and I saw everybody's hands doing the same thing.
Well, you were up first, Elaine. Tell us about it. Happened in New York.
Bert, this is so funny. It is incredible. What
we'll be the judge of that.
Okay, I'm sorry. It's so funny what happens because of this show. We're staying out here now. And we were going to sublease our apartment in New York. So a real estate broker was there, and he brought a party in to see the apartment. And they looked around and everything, and they said, very nice, very nice. And they said, does the color television set work? So the real estate broker said, we'll turn it on and see. He turns it on, and who do you think's on television?
Who could it be?
Me. I'm on the show, and he says, oh, this is the lady who owns this apartment, as a matter of fact. And I'm telling a story that I told about the apartment in New York, about the door that whistles.
Oh, I remember the story.
And I'm saying what a terrible apartment it is, because it's like a haunted apartment at night.
Oh, no.
And the guy turns to the real estate broker, and he says, I'm getting out of this apartment. This is a dog. I couldn't believe it. So they didn't take the apartment.
No kidding.
It's the truth.
About a coincidence.
And the guy called us up here in California and he said, I've got to tell you this. You will not believe it. You were on when he wanted to see the color television. Just incredible, isn't it?
Oh, it is incredible. And I believe it, too. And it happened in New York. And we need a one or two word clue now that Bobby's going to recognize.
Apartment. Oh, yes, it'll have apartment. I can't say sublease because that's two words.
Is sublease is one word.
One word?
That's what our producer says. He just held up a finger.
Sublease. Yeah, okay.
Sublease.
They love me now, but if he comes up wrong,
no,
they're going to hate me.
The red section is crazy about you. Don't you worry about a thing. Now, but let's not talk. We don't want to give it away. Bring on the fellas. Gentlemen, we have asked the ladies a question, and we have a clue. Here's the question first. It happened in New York. Okay, that's the question. The clue is sublease. Bobby. Tell us about that, Bobby, if you will,
that's
sir.
Funny, because it just happened, right? Is that the one with the showing the apartment and Tattletales was on?
That's the one.
Can you believe that? Unbelievable. Whee!
Isn't that incredible,
Bobby? I blew the rent, too. It's terrible, I'll tell you. Yeah, that's really... Isn't that fantastic, though? That's one of the greatest things I've ever heard in my life.
No way in the world... If Daryl Zanuck had walked in and turned on the television, you wouldn't be on, right? It'd be Love of Life.
That's who it was, Daryl Zanuck.
Okay, time for a tattletale quickie now. We'll play another one, and I'm going to reach for it. Here it comes. Fellas, I asked you the question. Each correct answer is worth $100. Here we go. Men, who would you fear more as an enemy? A man... Or a woman? Men, who would you fear more as an enemy? A man or a woman? Think about that. We'll come back to you in just a moment. Perplexed faces on those fellows. Amanda, what's Frank going to say?
Well, I think that Frank...
Good luck, Amanda.
Let's see. See, if Frank has a man enemy, then that he's on a one-to-one basis with a man, right?
Right.
Okay. What was the question?
Who would you fear more as an enemy, a man or a woman?
Oh, he'd fear a woman because he's been terrified of all his ex-wives.
Is that right? All of his ex-wives, you mean if they gang up on him, it's a crowd? Is that
right?
Okay, so you'll say a woman.
Yes.
He'll say a woman.
Say a woman.
All right, let's bring on Frank. Hello, Frank.
Howdy.
He's chuckling, too. Frank, who would you fear more as an enemy, a man or a woman?
Well, I don't think I'd be too concerned about a man. Some of these broads are doozies.
I think that means a woman. what she said, Frank. And I just want the women in the audience to remember it was Frank who said that. Frank said, some of these broads are doozies. I would never say that. You're right, Frank. Thank you. Okay, Marcy, what's Bill going to say?
Oh, this is really tough. I'm just going to guess. We never discussed it. I have no idea, so I'm going to say a woman for the same reasons, really.
Why? Because some of those broads can be doozies? Or...
Yes. No, I think he could deal with a man head on. I mean, he can deal with a woman head on, too. No, I don't know. I'll just say a woman.
You're just going to say, what the heck, it's a woman. All right, let's bring on Bill. Okay, Bill, which one would you fear most?
Well, I'd fear a man more than a woman.
Oh, boy, I heard the women scream. Yeah. Now I fear the women.
Well,
I just didn't know, so I said a woman.
Yeah, she just took a... she really didn't know what you were going to say.
Well, neither did I know what I was going to say.
That's right. And now that you've said it...
I'm sorry I did.
Sorry, no score, Bill. Thank you. Okay, Elaine, what's Bobby going to say?
This is like a soap opera plot, right? Men are much more decent than women. I mean, they really are. Dealing with a woman is almost impossible. You never know how they are, how they feel, or whatever they're thinking that day. So, for the same reasons, Bobby would say a woman, definitely.
He would fear a woman more.
Oh, yeah.
Unpredictable is the reason there.
Oh, yes, they can be vicious, you know, as men just are...
I'm just going to let you keep talking. This
and
is
hang myself. Victoria Steinem is waiting outside for me.
Okay, Bobby will say women. Let's bring him on. All right, Bobby?
Yeah.
What is the answer?
Well, you know, if I would... If
come on!
Bobby? There's nothing more vicious than a woman. What am I going to tell you?
At this point, Marcy and Bill have $100. Amanda and Frank have $200. Elaine and Bobby are in the lead with $300 for the red section. It's halftime, ladies. Ladies to the rear. Fellas, come on out here. While we're changing places, we shall break away for a brief message. Come back with us, please.
If you have trouble getting around and would love to regain your independence, Elected Mobility would like to give you a Rascal scooter free. Call for your free color catalog and enter the Rascal Mobility Sweepstakes. It's our way of introducing you to the benefits of owning a Rascal. Join over 100,000 Rascal riders who found Rascal to be the easiest to operate, easiest to transport, and easiest to afford. Your Rascal can be insurance or Medicare reimbursable.
My Rascal has given me a new lease on life.
I didn't get around much at home until I got my Rascal.
I was burdened other people. Now I'm independent.
I call it taking a walk. I jump on my Rascal and I take a walk.
Every month we give away another free Rascal. If you call right now, we'll give you up to 12 chances to win yours free. So call for your free color catalog. Call today. Don't delay. Next month's winner could be you.
To win a free Rascal, call 1-800-380-7171. That's 1-800-380-7171. Call now.
Before people, before cities, it was clear, untouched, new. It can be new again with Brita. It's certified to remove chlorine, sediment, 99% of lead. Brita. Tap water. Transformed.
We should greet each and every day like a gift that's come our way. Share the rich Folgers brew and make someone's day brighter too. That aroma mountain grown. Pass it on, set the morning's tone. Feel the warmth and say, let's unravel.
What's it? Okay, we are back. We have changed places, as you can see. I have the gentleman out here with me now, and we have a studio audience that's already winning some money. And if they're in the rooting section that is batting. Hi.
Hello.
And here we go again. The rooting section that's backing our top winning celebrity couple today, we will add a bonus of $1,000 to that rooting section. Oh. Okay.
What do I guess? Not my money.
The ladies are backstage all ready to go, aren't you? We're going to ask the fellas a question now. This is a story question this time. We'll come to you with a clue and a story from them in just a moment. All right,
is this
ladies?
A story?
Enjoy
story.
The music. Goodbye. Yeah, this is a story question now.
Right.
Goodbye, ladies.
Okay.
Can't tell it without them.
Goodbye.
Here we go. Ready to go?
Where's
hands
the
upon the table. You press the button. I'll only take one response, so you got to be first. Here it comes. First question. It happened before the wedding.
It happened when I proposed to her.
Really? You want to tell us the rest of that?
Well, we were in a city,
mm-hmm.
and...
Was it Pittsburgh, by any chance?
No, but don't say that magic word. And I was sitting romantically with my wife over candlelit dinner with the wine and the thing.
How do you sit romantically? What do you
well, I sit in her lap, actually.
I see.
And she said, are we ever going to get married? And I said...
check, please.
No, we weren't married, so I couldn't say checkmate, could I?
No.
I said, well, within the next 5 years.
Oh, that's good.
And she said, couldn't we make it a little sooner? So I said, well, any weekend we have free. And we got married about 2 weeks later.
Really? That's how it happened?
Yeah.
So she really asked you is what she did?
Yeah, that happened before the marriage.
Well, sure. Yeah, you
it
have
would
to
have
ask,
to, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I think right. so. Okay, it happened before the wedding. What we need is a clue.
What's a clue? Give me a clue. Weekend? Weekend.
Weekend?
Weekend. No. No?
The yellow section is yelling no. What?
Free weekend.
Free weekend is two words. It's two words. That's okay. You
yeah,
can
I think we
words.
Better go for two words, gang.
Okay.
Well, you lose it all. Free weekend.
Free weekend. Yeah. Two words. Worth $50. Let's bring on the ladies. Shh, 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 shh,
shh. Shh.
Very quiet.
Leak?
It's very quiet in here.
Why are we
whispering? We've asked the fellas a question and we have a clue. Now, here is the question voiced. It happened before the wedding. And the clue is free weekend.
Marcy!
Oh, yeah.
Tell us about that, Marcy.
Well, it's just really, we took a long time to get married, and finally I asked him when he thought we might, and to make long story short, he said the first free weekend.
That's exactly what he said, and you are right. Absolutely right. And so, at
moving?
This point, Marcy
sport,
Bill, you just scored it. You got $150. Amanda and Frank have $200. Elaine and Bobby still in the lead with $300. And we're going to come back and forth, Title Tales, in just a minute after this message for you. Please come back with us.
I didn't complain when you squeezed the Charmin. I didn't complain when you squeezed the fruit. But now I'm complaining because you're squeezing my blank.
Dream along with me.
He has had 148 songs on the pop chart spanning four decades, 50 top 10 hits, 14 number one hits.
Find a wheel and it goes round.
Now, Cornerstone Promotions brings you a classic collection by the great Perry Como.
Oh, hot diggity dog, diggity ho, what you do to me? It's so
one of the world's most beloved performers.
Don't let the stars get in your eyes, don't let them...
So many unforgettable hits.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket, never let it fade away.
Magic moments when two...
There's a special romantic feeling in his songs.
No other love have I.
This 40-song treasury features only Perry Como's biggest hits and inspirational you. Favorites.
Some enchanted evening.
Wanted someone who kissed me.
A.
You're adorable.
B.
You're so beautiful.
Till the end of time.
Papa loves Mambo. Mama loves Mambo.
Hoop-dee-doo, hoop-dee-doo.
I hear a polka and my troubles are through.
Cause I got me a real life Cupid doll.
She's the cutest one of them all. It's impossible.
Tell the sun to leave.
This special Perry Como collection is not available in any store. Here's how to order. Call this toll-free number now for Perry Como. Two cassettes, $19.98, two CDs, $26.98, plus $4.95 shipping. Have your credit card ready and call now.
Okay, we're back. Tattletale quickie time. I have the ladies on the screens, the gentlemen in their seats. Ready to go? Here comes the question, ladies. Girls, as a teenager, were you more popular with the girls or boys? As a teenager, were you more popular with the girls or with the boys? Think about that, ladies. And we'll come back to you in just a moment.
Hey, fellas.
Bye.
It was supposed to be a quickie.
Boy, that's
boy. I'm glad you didn't ask me that.
I have... Now, you stop it,
get your hand off my lap. Keep your hands above the table there, Bob.
Yeah. Frank, what's the matter with
you? I refuse to get involved in this one.
That's a hard question. That really is a tough one.
Talk about a doozy. This
yeah,
is it.
This is a doozy. Oh,
this is a real one.
Was she more popular with the girls or with the boys? What will Amanda say?
I would say that she was probably more popular with the girls. I've seen some of the pictures.
Yes. Yeah. So you would say...
Yes, can I have my bill, please?
Bill,
I'd like to leave.
Bill and Bob, will you stop trying to bail him out? He knows what he means.
He's got something like from here up to about here. Is that what you're talking about?
Well,
that,
that's the biggest photograph I've ever seen, if it's up to him.
That's the girl's size, right?
You mean
size when she was a teenager.
As a teenage girl, you think that she was more popular with the girls.
I think where she grew up, I don't think they had boys.
Oh, moving right along, folks. Let's bring on Amanda. Amanda.
Yes.
My dear.
Yes.
Who were you more popular with as a teenager, the boys or the girls?
Oh, dear. Well, I really, I had friends with, I was friends with both species. But I, you see, I have this problem, and I like boys.
Yeah.
So I guess I'd have to say boys. Mm-hmm.
You didn't have to say boys.
Not at all.
Obviously,
you didn't. But you did, and I'm sorry, because Frank said girls.
What does he know?
He said he saw some pictures. Well, never mind. It's all right. Thank you, Amanda. Sorry, no score there. Okay, Bill, your turn.
I'm sorry.
Oh, well. Well, it wasn't so long ago that she was a teenager.
Right.
She was actually, I think she was more popular with the girls at the time. I think that's where interest lies.
Okay. You say the girls.
Trust me, gang, I've been wrong, yeah.
Let's see what...
Let's see what
Marcy says. Shh, shh. All right, Marcy, who was it? More popular with the boys or the girls?
The boys.
Oh. I can never say that to you again, gang.
See you this There's always a first time, isn't there, Bill? Sorry, he said the other ones, you know.
Yeah.
Sorry about that, Marcy.
Whatever
thank you. No score there.
Oh, dear.
Okay, Bobby.
All right. You ready, gang?
Yeah.
I'm the only one who's going to say she's more popular with the boys. Absolutely.
Yeah, Bobby,
what?
Bobby, are you keeping in mind the question is as a teenager, not now?
No, I'm talking about a teenager. What's the difference? She's still cute.
The boys.
She was cute when she was young.
Let's bring her on. Elaine.
Yeah.
Who were you more popular with, the boys or the girls?
Well, you see, I used to have a bad habit of showing my panties. So I was more popular with the boys.
Hey, our time is up. That's all the time we have, and that means our winners for today are Elaine and Bobby. Bobby, you have won $400 for your rooting section. We had $1,000 for that, for a total of $1,400. And we're going to come right back with more of Battle Tales in just a moment after this message for you.
Get ready to play.
Love. Hate.
Despair.
You'll see it all on the original Newlywed Game. And then, the game of love continues. Bob Eubanks is back on the new Newlywed Game. Catch the Newlywed Game at 7:30 p.m. Eastern, 4:30 p.m. Pacific, followed by the new Newlywed Game, weekdays on Game Show Network.
Mr. Sandman.
Remember when a quarter bought you three songs on the jukebox? And where you had the most fun hanging out with your friends?
Young love, first love.
Now relive those malt shop memories with 36 of the most romantic songs to ever come out of a jukebox.
Since I met you, baby, my whole life has changed. Earth angel, will you be mine? Heavenly shades of night are falling, it's twilight time. 16 candles.
Malt Shop Memories brings you 36 unforgettable songs by the greatest idols of the time.
See the pyramids along the Nile. Come with me, my love. Teen angel, can you hear me?
I'm sorry now.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation.
Corn of the food.
Oh yeah.
I was a fool.
All I have to do is dream. Cause I want girl to call my own.
Malt Shop Memories, 36 all-time classics on two cassettes or two CDs. Here's how to order.
Have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-361-0990. That's 1-800-361-0990. Call from U.S. or Canada. That's 1-800-361-0990. Or send $19.98 for two cassettes or $26.98 for two CDs plus $4.95 shipping to Malt Shop Memories, P.O. Box 1600, Libertyville, Illinois. Up next on Game Show Network plays Super Decades, followed by Trivia Track and The Price is Right.
Goodbye.
Bye.
This is Jack Clark speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Game Show Network. All play, all day.
Tonight, one of our lucky players will have a chance to win our final decade's jackpot, which is worth... on Super Decade! And now, here's your host, Marianne Curran.
Come on, everybody, do the Super Decade Shuffle. Yeah, come on. You're in your living rooms now. I know, it's Friday. You're kicking back. We're working. Don't worry about us. Okay. Hi, I'm Marianne Curran. Welcome to the show. The only show, the one and only show that you should be watching. And you are. Thank you. This is our little game. It's just a little thing that takes you traveling through time. We ask you questions about events and when they took place. We like answers. We like correct answers. We have two games tonight. The winner of each receives a nice prize and then gets to compete for more goodies. And a growing Final Decades jackpot. It has worked its little self up to $2,438 and eight prizes. Two players for our first game. Returning champion, Robin Candelario from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. And joining her tonight, Kevin Sable from New Haven, Connecticut. Welcome to the show. Robin, how you doing tonight?
Oh, fine. In fact, my sister lives about 10 minutes from New Haven.
All right. Well, I hope she's watching. Does she have this on her cable or dish or whatever?
They do, and I left a message on their phone. Please, please watch. Hi, little niece Morgan.
Okay. Well, Robin, let's remind the folks which one of the characters you chose yesterday. Ah, there she is, my favorite gal. And do you have your gang watching tonight?
Yes, and Billy's back from camp.
Hi, Billy. Sorry you missed us yesterday. Hi, everybody. Okay. Robin, nice to have you and your family back. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
All right, and hello to all the cadiddles. Kevin up next. How you doing, Kevin?
Okay, Marianne, how are you?
Very well. Nice to have you here. Let's get one of our little wacky characters lined up for you. Just press the number that goes with the photo now. I love the way they lock that in there. It sounds like the prison gate's shutting. Any number will do there, Kevin. There he is. It's a manly choice, the firefighter. Yes. And what do you do there in New Haven, Kevin?
I'm retired right now, but I used to do that.
You were a fireman?
Yes.
Well, wonderful, wonderful. I have such respect for you guys. It's an incredible job that you guys do. And are you enjoying your retirement?
Oh, yes.
All right. What are you doing for fun?
Oh, I go golfing and play with the kids and do all kinds of things like that.
Good for you. Who's watching tonight?
My sons, Kevin, Brian, and Jason, and my wife, Carol.
Kevin, Brian, Jason, and Carol. Nice to have the family here, and good luck to you, Kevin.
Thank you.
All right, let's play some Super Decades. I'm going to read a question, give you three choices. You can't enter an answer, though, till you see three lines.
Zippers, you know you got a big video when you got Ben Folds doing your cameo. Suits are picking up the bill coming up. Estero as well right now, Brian Setzer.